Sliding menus are everywhere. In this video, I'm going to show you how to slide in a menu from the right, from the left, from bottom, even from the top. You can swipe to dismiss or tap to dismiss. Also, the menu can be as wide as you want it to and can contain anything that you can think of. Alex here from Rebeloper.com. Smash that subscribe button and let's find out how you can add a sliding menu to your SwiftUI app. Now, if you want to have a 16-minute Zoom call with me where we can talk about your SwiftUI project, or I can teach you SwiftUI or Swift, or you just want to hang out with me and take a look at your code, maybe I will fix some bugs in that, take a look at rebeloper.com/mentoring. And if you want a free 16-minute Zoom call with me, go ahead and comment on this video, like this video, because in the next one, I will be drawing out a winner, one winner for a free mentoring session. And today, also, we are going to draw a winner for the previous video. So go ahead and make sure to stay to that inside the video. So today, we are going to talk about slide in view. I have prepared kind of a starter project here, and I will just go through it really, really fast. Here we have a tab view, we have a home and profile view inside RAM, inside navigation views, of course, and also we have the home right over here. It's a scroll view with some cells, and the profile is kind of the same with some different cells, like the cells are the same, but the data is different, and here is the actual data. Okay, so basically that's it. Let me just build and run this so you can take a look at how this looks like currently. It's really straightforward. A tab bar, a tab view with some navigation, and a scroll view right inside of there. Okay, so as you can see here, we have a button. If I tap on this button, it says did tap menu button. And this is where we are going to implement our slide in menu. Of course, for that, you will need to take a look at the resources where you can download the slide in view file, which I will add right now. So if you download the resources from the link, you will see that we have a slide in view. So let's just drag and drop that right over here. Let's click on finish. And you can take a look at the slide in view file when you download it, but let's just use it. And let's just go into the home view, and I already did prepare this did tap menu button. So actually, this is where I want to trigger this. So let's just start off by creating some sort of a menu for ourselves. So what I will do is just create here a new file, and I will just call this, it will be a simple SwiftUI view. Let's click on next, and let's add a menu. So menu view maybe. So that would be our menu view, and I would just say here, hello, menu view. Okay, and that's it for now. We will just add in here some more, so it will be actually a simple, a real menu like view, but for now, let's just use this. And how would we set all of this up? Well, there is some documentation in the slide in view, but of course you are watching this video, so I will show it to you. First of all, we need to create some sort of state for the menu. Is it shown or not? Is it presented or not? So we are going to create a simple observable object that we are going to initiate right over here. So again, let's just create a new file, and I would just create a simple Swift file, and let's call this slide in view. Let's just call it service. Let's just call it slide in menu. Why not? So slide in menu service. There we go. Let's create that. Let me just have some more room right over here. Let's just import SwiftUI because this will be an observable object. Let's create our class, slide in menu service, and that will be an observable object. Let's create our is presented published variable. So at published var is presented. There we go. And by default, that would be false. Okay, let's hit Command B. Let's see if everything observable, sorry, right over here, not observed, but observable. Auto completion, it's really, really You just want to hit something and you hit another. So observable object has this is presented. So now what we want to do is make this available throughout our app. Now, why would we want to make this available throughout the app? Well, first of all, there are some stages where you can add this slide in menu according to what you want, what you actually want this to menu to look like. So I've just prepared this example to encompass all of those scenarios. So let's start off by having a private state object right over here called slide in menu. Slide in menu service. Okay, and that would be slide in menu service. Okay, and all you have to do is just add that slide in menu service as an environment object. So what I will do, I grab the tab view, add a group to it. So a group, and then move the tab view right over here. Basically, what I want to achieve is have this slide in menu set as an environment object on all of our views. So I just go environment object and slide in menu service. So not the slide in menu view, sorry. The slide in menu service should be an environment object. So now on the home view right over here, I can access it. And I will access it as an environment object. And yeah, let's just copy out some stuff right over here. Slide in menu. And that is slide in menu of type slide in menu service, slide in menu service. So now I have access to that is presented. And yeah, let's just go and have that on the dit tab menu, just toggle it. So slide in menu service dot is presented dot toggle. Why not? Okay, and I will just remove this print statement. So now we are kind of having that trigger already. So where do we actually put our slide in view? Because it's called a slide in view, either it's a menu or whatever you'd like, because you will see how flexible that is. So let's just go back right over here and maybe let's just do this on the group. So we just have, to make it even more readable, let's add the slide in view right over here. And you can see there are two initializers for this view modifier. One is isActive and content, and the other one with some more stuff. So let's just take a look at the one that is active, edge, padding percentage, options, and content, because otherwise you would just use the default values. So isActive. Well, we just go slide in menu service. Is presented, and I think we have to add the dollar sign right over here. Now there is edges, so as you can see, we can have leading, bottom, top, trailing. So for now, let's just use trailing. The default one is leading, by the way. Padding percentage, it's from 0 till 1, but I would just go and remove this right now. What this means is how far should the padding be, between the edge of our screen and the edge of our menu. So actually what you can see beneath the menu, what is underneath the menu, and that type of percentage. Okay, and then we have some options here, and there's quite a lot. Padding color opacity, should dismiss upon swipe or should dismiss upon external tab. Now, padding color, you see when you are having this sliding on top of your view, that will have a color on the view itself. And also you have a color opacity for that color. And should dismiss upon swipe, do you want this to be dismissed on the swipe? So the menu, if you swipe on the menu, say yes, true or false right over here, or should dismiss upon external tab, meaning if you tap on this padding where you can actually see the underlying view. If you set this to true, then if you tap right over there, you will having the menu dismissed. By the way, both of them are set to true. And I really like the padding color and the padding opacity. It's actually some sort of a gray, okay? And then I have this content. Well, the content is our menu view. Real nice. And that's it. What did you know? That's all it takes. Of course, we need to set up our menu view, like the UI of our menu view, a little bit more, because yeah, you will see in just a second. Let's just tap over here, and there it is. As you can see, it's not that pretty, but if I tap on it again, it just goes away. Really, really nice. Okay, so now let's make our menu view really better. So first thing first, what I want to do is make this experiment and have a background. So first of all, let's create a V-stack right over here, and then maybe let's create a horizontal stack, and let's just have this right in here, and just add a spacer right over there, and then also a spacer right over there, and finally we are going to have also some spacers for our vertical stack also. So spacer. So let's build it run and see how this looks like already. So it's the same thing, yes, because we forgot to add a background color. So we want to add a background, and the background will be a color of, let's say, UI color of system background. Let's just have this system background. Let's see how this looks like. Okay, so now there we go. Much, much better. Of course, it is covering all of our tab bar up, which is the case in our case because we have added to the group, so everything. So it's a good thing that we left the tab outside of our menu to dismiss it. So if I tap right over there, it's dismissing it. As you can see, really nice. Also, if I swipe, it's going to dismiss it. Let's do that again. Swiping, dismissing it. Really, really nice. Of course, you can tweak this. So let's say I don't really want to, I would rather have this button on top. So how would we do that? Well, if we just go right over here and let's move our slide in view, I'm just going to hit Command X to copy all of that out. And let us just put it on the home. So right over here, we are having the toolbar. So kind of like here. So yeah, we do have the side in menu service, all of that stuff. This is why it's so important that we created that observable object. So there we go. Now we have actually access to this tab bar because, and let me just have this right over here so we can see that actually we have that navigation bar, right? So this is how it is. So now it's not covering the tab bar or the navigation bar. And yeah, it depends on your choice. You can add this as you wish to. Of course, I would prefer the other way around. So let me just move this back and put it right over here. Build and run one final time. There we go. Hello, menu view. Okay, this is really, really nice. But what if I want to set this to the leading part? So yeah, let's take a look at that. Now, if I tap right over here, it's coming from the leading part. Really, really nice. How about the top? This is so, so powerful. As you can see, if I tap right over here, it's dismissing. Also, if I slide up, it will be better. So also, we can have it as a button, like a slide up button right over there. Hello, menu view. Really, really nice. Of course, you can set the height of it with the modifiers that you already saw when you are creating the slide in view with that percentage of the padding. Again, let me just remind you what the padding is. This part is the padding. So how much it should be padded. Really, really nice. Okay, so let's take this back to trailing. Trailing, there we go. And now let's check out our winner for the previous video. Make sure that you like and subscribe to the channel and comment on this video to have a chance on the next video for a draw. Now I'm going to draw a lucky winner for a 60-minute Zoom call with me from the previous video. So I will grab this URL and put it right over here. And let's just fetch. Okay. And let's continue. And there we go. Let's pick a winner. And the winner is W0 Ombless. Well, most probably I didn't spell it out right. What you want to do is just contact me at support@rebeloper with your email that you made your comment with. And I'm looking forward for your free 60-minute Zoom call. And if you do want to learn more why 95% of self-taught developers fail, go ahead and check out this video right over here.